No, 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 too tight. Trying to be careful not to nick the edges. That's pretty good. A little gap here. But it's hitting here. So I take a little bit off the rim here. Hopefully this will push in a little bit more. Okay, that's better. That's good. Okay, well, that fits. Oops. Little gap. The slant needs to go a little bit more. It wants to go a little too wide. Okay, there's a significant gap here and gap on this side. So that tells me the gusset is too long. So it's preventing the rim from moving down. So we need to take off probably 1/16. So about this much. The gap is gone. Nice gap here, even. getting there. A little bit of the corner is hitting, and here. Pretty good. Almost there. See here, there's a high spot. Actually, I want to trim the backrest. The same on this side. And there's a little gap here. But I think that will disappear once we get this to seat. Take small cuts, a little bit at a time. Getting there, gap here, little gap here, the back fits good, I might go deeper, and this side, I need to go deeper on the edge, so make sure it seats, yeah. That's pretty good. Maybe a little bit more in the front. It's good, but a little bit more will make it perfect. Looks good. This side is quite a bit higher. This side too. So we're gonna file this at an angle so that it just starts to go in. But I'm being careful not to nick the sides. Okay, a little bit. It's starting to go in. You can see a little mark here and here. So that tells me that I need to start from here and go in. Almost there, a little bit more. That's pretty good. So you see there's a slot in the middle. There's a bigger end and there's a smaller end. So this is tapered. So I'm going to make a pin that'll fit this taper, and when we drive it in, it will force the gap close. So we start with the blank like this. And this is going to be tapered on four sides. I take my plane and just hit the front. Enough. And then I'm gonna shape this so that the sides are tapered. So that's the big end, that's the small end. I want to make sure this at least fits in here. The small end fitting the small end. Oops. Oh, sorry. A bit more. Starting to go in. That's close. Let's try it. Okay, it's pretty close, but it's not coming out the other side. That means we need to shape the big end smaller so that it will come out. Again, little bit by little bit. Yeah. You hear how the sound changed? That tells me I bottomed out. That is perfect. That's what you want to see. Coming almost straight off the CNC. Cool. Yeah, it's not coming out. I'm gonna number it. That's number 4. 3, it's 2, it's 4, that's 1. Cool. So 1 to 1. Number 1 pin. I love this part. The joint just draws together. And then number 4 to number 4. Tight. There. Oh, wrong side. That's why. So that was number 3. See how the joint draws together? Beautiful. And the last one, number 2. I hope you can see. Yeah, I can see. There's my pin. That was the problem we had here. It looks pretty even. So there it is. Very, very stiff. There's no play at all. Very stiff. And when it's connected to the legs, it will not move. Now, I leave the wooden pegs untrimmed. at this point, the wood still might move and slight adjustments might still be needed. So I keep it long so I can either drive it in or taper it to fit better or whatever. But I wait till the very last minute. There it is. Done.